Good morning to all. And it is interesting to see that there are many attendees right at 10 a.m. Maybe we have started a little early. As far as the lockdown is concerned, many people are sleeping late, getting up late, and that's understandable. But then again, there are a lot of participants right at the morning, which shows that many people are interested to learn virtual reality and augmented reality. I am Bishwajoy Chatterjee, the Vice Chancellor of University of Engineering and Management, UEM Jaipur. And alongside me, you are seeing Mr. Shreyashkam Ghoshal. He is an expert as far as this virtual reality and augmented reality is concerned. He has developed several apps, several applications on virtual reality and augmented reality. And here in this two-day workshop, he will be showing that how you build applications on virtual reality and augmented reality. Industry is moving towards Industry 4.0. There is a revolution in the industry. It is changing to Industry 4.0. And all of you will agree that this virtual reality and augmented reality is very much a part of that. And when you join an industry, as I can expect that all of you over here are students. So when you join an industry, it will be expected from you that you will be able to build virtual reality and augmented reality applications. So Mr. Shreyashkam Ghoshal, in this two-day workshop today and tomorrow, he will be showing how virtual reality and augmented reality applications are built. So welcome to this wonderful session. Thank you, Mr. Shreyashkam, for conducting this. And it's all over to you now. You may start the workshop and you may teach your students. Thank you so much.
So good morning, everyone. Today we are going to start with a brief description of what is the differences between the reality in which we are living and the reality which we can bring to the real world. Let's start with a presentation. Okay, so firstly, reality. What is reality? The state of things as they actually exist in the real world is what reality is. Like this, we can feel, see things that are moving around. We can walk through them. We can do whatever stuff. We can hold a phone in our hand. That's the reality which we are facing in our day-to-day life. But other than that, there is another reality which we are unaware about, and that's extended reality. So extended reality refers to all real and virtual environments generated by computer graphics and variables. The X you can see in the extended reality here, the X is simply a variable that can stand for any letter. XR is like an umbrella category that covers all various forms of computers, like augmented reality, mixed reality, virtual reality. All these are covered under this XR category. See, all of them together make the XR family. And let's start with a topic many of us are already familiar with, that is virtual reality. So virtual reality encompasses all virtual immersive experiences. This could be created using purely real world content like 360 videos, purely synthetic content like computer generated videos, or a hybrid of both. This medium requires the use of head mounted devices like HTC Vive, Oculus 3D, Google Cardboard. We have used it once in our life at least. So let's begin with an introductional video of how VR works in real world.
Samsung has made the exciting world of virtual reality a reality with Gear VR Innovator Edition. Powered by Oculus and the Galaxy Note 4, Gear VR is a virtual reality headset that lets you experience games, movies, and more like never before. You simply insert the Galaxy Note 4 into place and put it on. Then select Milk VR and get ready to be amazed. You're going to want some serious sound.
Whoa, what a view.
Gear VR plunges you into a totally immersive 360 environment. What do you think?
Feels like I'm really there.
You can see things from a whole new perspective. Ready for another adventure? navigate menus, explore worlds, and play games by simply turning your head, swiping, and tapping the side-mounted touchpad.
Now I'm on a Safari.
Your VR brings the experience to life. And where are you? I'm in a really intense battle. Take that.
Boom! Red kick!
It's like the best seat in the house. Up, down, side to side, even behind you. Everywhere you look, you're in the action. Wow. And it all happens on the Super AMOLED screen on the Galaxy Note 4. The world of virtual reality is finally here. The Samsung Gear VR Innovator Edition, powered by Oculus and the Galaxy Note 4.
So we just saw a video where we are demonstrated about the Samsung Galaxy VR, which was built, I guess, in 2016 or 15. And it created a great hype in the world market. But actually, the concept of VR was introduced back in 1838. And we have also used it when we were kids like this. We have always, once in a life, where we have used this device. We need to click this button over here, and the scene used to change. This is called a stereoscope. A stereoscope is the first introduction or our first encounter with VR, virtual reality. We have used this, we have seen various scenes like a scene of aquarium or a zoo inside this lenses. So this was the first introduction we got to know when we first encountered VR in our real life. And this was the man, Sir Charles Wheaton, who invented stereoscope back in 1838, and it opened the world for the studies of binocular vision. This was the stereoscope he built, where two pictures were attached, on one on the left side, one on the right side, and two mirrors were attached in a 45 degree angle, and they reflected the pictures like this, and people used to see it from the spectacle like object present here. And this was the first VR which officially people used in back in 1838. And then eventually in the 19th century, it developed into a handheld VR device, where also we use two pictures in order to feel that we are present in a different world. And from that day, it has changed a lot. We have used Google Cardboard, which is a cardboard VR, which is accessible to everyone. We can buy it in Amazon, Flipkart, any of the online retailing stores. Then we have slot-ins, where we just put our camera, mobiles inside, and we can view virtual reality as well as augmented reality using that phone. We just need this handheld device. And then we have this head-mounted ones. We have Oculus 3D, then Microsoft HoloLens. And as the time goes on, the size and the accessibility of the device are becoming very cheap and very comfortable for us. Means it's becoming sleeker, lighter, and more fashionable and more suitable for everyone to use. One, and we are now trying to achieve something like a lens, which we can wear in our eyes, and we don't need to wear those big head-mounted devices, and just wearing a lens will do. So one day, surely we will achieve this. Many of the researchers and developers are working on this. But the virtual reality is quite common in all of us. We have already used it or seen it in some of the instances. But the thing which is more important in today's world is augmented reality. As we don't always want to change our location, but we want to integrate or augment anything which is not present over here. Suppose I'm sitting over here and I want to integrate something from outer world or something which is not present over here inside the world which I'm sitting in. So let's begin what augmented reality is. So as you can see in the picture, the man is in a room where he has bought this globe type thing in his hand, but actually it isn't existing over here. So this is augmented reality, where we can interact with objects which aren't present in real life, but we can do various stuff with that. So let's begin a video where we will see it, how it works.
Step over the boundaries of your smartphone screen with AirTitan. Experience a full interaction with your enhanced reality firsthand. Get involved in something you've never dreamt of. Or be a part of something impossible. Meet the ancient giants from the distant past. Build your own private zoo. Gain a better access to information. Have the wonders of the universe in the palm of your hand. Or nothing is out of reach or out of dream. It's a perfect combination of AR hardware and believable contents. It's AR Titan for a hands-on AR experience.
So AR Titan is just a device which can help us visualize augmented reality stuff in real world. And then we have mixed reality where we combine both of them, means virtual reality as well as augmented reality. But that's a huge topic which we won't cover today. We will talk about virtual reality and augmented reality more. So let me introduce you some of my projects which I have built over the years. So this was my first project which I built for my university.
Hello everyone, this is our IMUEM group augmented reality card. Whenever we click on any of the logos present on the card, an introductional video starts to play on air, which can be visualized with the help of a smartphone camera.
Institute of Engineering and Management started its journey in 1989, and thus,
this was the first app which I developed almost 2 years back. Then after that, we have all seen Doraemon, where there was an anywhere door. We can open the door, and Doraemon used to go to different places with that door. So I have also made that project on my own. Let me show you. And then finally, I worked with a company named AR House, where they are the main focus of the company was to make based on interior decoration, where they used to whenever we buy a plot, so that we can see what our house or our room will actually look when we add furnitures inside it. So we just augment the furnitures over there, so that we can get an idea of how our room will look when the real furnitures will come in. So let's play the video how it works. I have worked in this company. It's a company from England, AR House. All the 3D models you see over here, the sofa, the vase, were designed by me. Thank you. So this is all which I wanted to show you as an introduction to virtual reality and augmented reality. Now we will get started with how we can build an application, which all of us can build and then use it as our first ever VR application or AR application. Today we will start with the AR technologies, and tomorrow we will begin with virtual reality. So let's begin. So the software which we require to build any of the application in AR, VR, or in game development, anything related to 3D, is Unity Hub or Unity. So in order to download it, let's show you how to install Unity. So we need to go to Google and then just type in Unity Hub. And the first links that popped up, we need to click over there. And here we can see download Unity Hub, not this one, download Unity plus download, choose your Unity plus download, download Unity Hub. And we click on it. I have already downloaded the Unity Hub version for my computer, so I won't do this process as it takes a long time. So when you click on this download button, it automatically downloads. And this one, the icon you can see over here, this one shows up on your desktop. And when you click on it, the Unity Hub software opens. Okay, that's the Unity Hub software. Now in the installation part, firstly, you have to sign in with your login ID, username, all this. You can sign in over here. Then we go to the installation part. And we need to download any version which we are suitable with. We need to from here. There is an add button over here. We need to click on it. And we need to download any of the versions. Suppose I need to download this version, Unity 2019.3.15. So I will click on it. There is already a blue mark. Then I will select on next. And we have to always make sure that Android build support is ticked. This will come like this on your device. We will have to check this one. If you want to make device an app for your iOS, then you have to click on this. For anything for MacBook, for Windows, you need to click this for Windows. For MacBook, you need to click this one. iOS build support and Android build support. Android JDK, SDK, NDK, all will be downloaded with it. Then you just click on the next button and it will start downloading. After downloading, you will get something like this over here, installation. And you will see what are the modules that are being downloaded over here, like the Android build support, iOS, Mac, Windows, JavaScript, anything which we have already downloaded. And anything extra you need, you just need to click on the three dots over here and add modules. And the rest of the thing, like Linux build support, anything if one day you need, you can just click on it and just do the next button over here, so that you can install the Unity version. So let's see what we are going to build today. The first application which you are going to build today is like a globe that will be present in front of you, and you can control it in your in the palms of your hand. So this is how we launch Unity. We'll explain all the parts of Unity. It's a very big software with a lot of details in it. We need to explain all the parts. So this is basically a software. I'm showing you a demo that what we are going to build today, and it will look like this whenever you click on the play button. So whenever we show this card, you will see a globe which is revolving or rotating. It's shown on the fingertips of my hand. You can see. So this is the application which we are going to build today. Very simple application, but takes a lot of precision. So let's get started. So let's close this one and build a new project. So in order to build a new project, we just go into the Unity Hub and then click on new over here. And let's then we will select the 3D option over here. There, when you build a game on 2D, you can select over here, but we are working on 3D platform, so we will select the 3D over here and name it as AR art and create one. The new project will be created over here. It takes a little bit of time as it's a 3D platform, so the rendering process takes a little bit of time. That is the view which you are going to get when you open a Unity software. So here is the main scene on which we are going to work with the 3D objects. It's the hierarchy where we are going to add the 3D objects, any object related to the application we are going to add over here, means any physical object. And the inspector window, we are going to change the settings of all the objects added over here, like the main camera added over here. We can change the settings over here, the transform, the position of the camera can be changed from this transform thing. Then we can change the skybox. You can see a blue color sky over here. We can change the color of it, like we can make it black, deep color, anything like that. But now we will leave as it is, as it won't, it would hamper our project. Then there are directional lights. And whenever we place a 3D object in this place, some sort of light is required to visualize it. So there is an artificial lighting given by 3D Unity, like a sun, that will fall on the object and make us help us in visualizing the object. But one problem over here is we have the main camera. The main camera is used when we use to build a game in for our mobile phone or for our computer. Means we can't access the camera of our phone. We will be only we can't see the background of our phone. Like in the previous project which I saw we saw my face was visible, everything was visible, and on my hand the art started rotating. But here, as the main camera is selected, we have to change it or replace it with AR camera, that is augmented reality camera. And for that we need to go to the asset store over here. You can see there is scene, game, and asset store. In asset store, we just click on it. In asset store, we have thousands and thousands of free assets which we can use for our project. There are many assets which are paid, but we don't require it as there is a huge amount of free assets present over there. So over here, we just click on search button and we have to download one SDK file. So that's the Vuforia engine, which will help us with the augmented reality camera, Vuforia engine. You just click on it and you can see it is a little bit of hazy. That means I have already downloaded it. When you were you will click on it, you will see a button. Let me show you. So here you will see I have this import button over here, but in your case, when you will start for the first time, you will see there will be written download. First, you need to download. It's a 25.7 MB file, which is quite accessible. So first we need to download, and after downloading it, every time, whenever you create a new project, you just need to import it. If you click on import and give the access to your Unity, and the package from the Unity Vuforia engine will be imported. Here you will again get an option, a small one, where it's written that import. We'll click on it and the package will be imported. This is the thing which all we need to import always for VR, AR, everything, because this provides the augmented reality camera. The main camera has no use over here. When you are working on virtual reality or augmented reality, the main camera don't have any. It's only used when we are making games in Unity. But whenever we are working on this augmented reality and virtual reality, we need to import this Vuforia engine. So it takes a little bit of time to import. So you can see many folders have been opened over here. This happens when you import the Vuforia engine. So now we go back to the scene where we started everything. And now we don't need this main camera. In replace of that, we need an AR camera, which we can get from the game object. Here in the top, we have game object. And down there, we have Vuforia engine. Inside Vuforia engine, we have AR camera. That's augmented reality camera. We just need to click on it. And yes, the AR camera is imported inside this hierarchy. So this is the AR camera and this is the main camera. We can't differentiate it right now. So we just need to delete this main camera, which is not required in this project. So we just click on this AR camera. And inside this AR camera, we will do all the stuff that is required to make this project. So firstly, we will see on the right hand bottom corner, you will see there is open Vuforia engine configuration where we have to set a license key. We always, whenever we build a project, we need a license key for ourselves. We need to open it. You will see app license key. So from where will we get it? So we need to go back to our Google and we just need to type here Vuforia. Vuforia, Vuforia. This is the Vuforia developer portal. We need to click on it. This is the portal from where we get the picture. You saw in my project, I used a card, a King of Spades, where we displayed the globe. So we need to import that image from here. So firstly, if you are not signed in, you have to. You will see. Let me show you. Let me log out how it works. When you first open, you will see a login option and a register option over here. For the first time, you have to register, and from then on, you have to just log in. And they will automatically save your password, and you can just log in, click on login, and your account will be open. So I have many things over here, which I will show you how to get. Firstly, we need to get the license key. For that, we have to click over here, get development key. On clicking it, you will see we have to add a license name. So we have named our project as AR Earth. So we will also name it the same over here so that we avoid confusion. And by checking in this box, we confirm that we want this. So on confirming, we will see that AR Earth is created over here in the name section, AR Earth. We'll click on it. And an auto-generated license key will be formed. This is the license key which you are going to get. We just click on it and it's copied on the clipboard. We just click on it and copy to clipboard. Then we go back to Unity, our software, and just click over here and Control V. We need to paste it and Control S, or we can also go to files and just save. So this license key will be saved over here. This license key is very important. If you don't add the license key, you will not be able to launch the application. So after adding the license key, we again go back to AR camera. Now we have to import an image where we will display the 3D objects, or where we will augment the 3D object. So in order to do that, again, we go to game objects, Vuforia engine, and we set an image target. The image target on which we will augment the object, 3D object. So let's click on it. the image target below the AR camera image target, you will see these two are in same line. The directional light over here on the left side and the AR camera are in same line. The image target is a little bit on the right side, and you can see an arrow, downward arrow over here. So this arrow means that this image target is a child of the AR camera. Whenever you bring it out, it will be same as a, it will be the super class. Whenever you pull it inside the AR camera, it will become a child, and we always need to do it. Otherwise, it won't display anything on the screen. We need to make all the objects that we are working on, we need to make the child of this AR camera. So after setting that, we have to set an image where we will display the 3D object. So I have already clicked an image of the card that I'm going to use. So this is the image. You can use any scanner, like Adaptscan or anything, even the normal camera will do. You just need to click the image, crop the image, and upload it on your PC. Then we need to go to our this Qfolia developer portal, and we have already created the license manager. We don't need this anymore. We have to go to target manager, as we have to set the image target. We will click on the target manager, and we will add a database over here. On the right hand side, there is a database option where we will add that database, and we will take it from the device. We will also name it as AR Art. Acha. Something is written over here. Database name must have no space and can only contain letters. Make sure that there must be no space in between both of them. So we have to remove the space, AR Art. And this is the name of our database. We will create it. And we will see it's listed inside the database list. We will double click on it, and this will open. And we have to set a target image. So we will click on add target. And as it is a 2D image or a single image, we will select this one. When we will work on cuboid, cylinders, or any 3D object or any 3D body, we will select these options. But now we are working on a single image, so we will select it. And we need to browse the image from here. So we will click on it. And my image is on desktop. In desktop, this is the image, I guess. Yes, this is the image. And we will open it over here. And let's set the height width as 5. This is enough for our work. We don't need to set it in the extreme level like 500 or 5000. We just need to set it at 5, 3, 4. That will do. And we just click on add in the below over here. And the target image will be uploaded. You have to wait for a while. And it takes a little bit of time for processing the image. This processing takes a lot of time, as all the points, all the colors, and all the contrast inside the image are being detected using an AI which is present in the Qfolia engine. So let's wait. Yes, now the image is done. The image is uploaded in this Qfolia portal. Now you can see there is a rating over here. That's a 5-star rating. That means the image has quite a bit of points which we can detect using our camera. If the rating is below 3-star, you should change the image. Because you have to have an image which has above 3-star rating. Whenever you upload, it will automatically rate the image. And you need to have an image that will have at least a rating above 3 or 3-star. Okay. If you place, if you get a rating below 3-star, then the image detection will have a great issue while making the application. So we just click on the image. This is the image which we uploaded. We got a 3-star rating. And let's show you the marks. These are the features. These are the features which will be detected. We have an option over here, show features. We just need to click on it and all the features will be shown. This will be detected using our camera so that we can view the 3D object over it. If the points are less, the augmented reality, this mark will go down and the rating will go down. So we need to upload an image that has a lot of contrast, a lot of marks, which will help in uploading the 3D object over it. So just we need to click on it, you know, check it and download the database. This database needs to download it. So we are not downloaded for Android Studio or anything else. We are downloaded for Unity Editor. So we will click on Unity Editor, select it and just download. Okay, so the download is done. So we need to minimize it. And I have to go in my downloads folder. Here it is, the AR art. This is what we downloaded just now. So this is a package also. Likewise, we imported the Vuforia package in our Unity folder. This is also a package. Just we need to do one thing. We need to minimize it a little and drag this package inside this. There is a asset resources. We just need to drag and drop over here. And you will see an imported button, import button will come. Just click on it. The package will be imported. So now you may have a question where the package we can't see. So for that, we need to click on image target. And from here, the type of package we have imported, it's a database image. So from database, it's written over here, from image. We have to click from database. And after that, here are two options, database, image target. You have to click on empty and see we have the AR art. And see the 3D object is over here. The card on which we will place all the 3D objects are over here. So we have just gone to this, we have selected the image target option. We have gone to type over there. We have selected from database as it is from the database. We have selected this file from the database. And then we need to select the AR database target. And here we will see the AR art option. If you have any more else database, like if we have three or four databases over here, all of them will be shown here in a drop-down menu. You have to just select it from here. We have selected it. Now let's just do a simple task. Let's just add, we have to right click over here, add a 3D object, and let's just add a cube to see if it's working perfectly. So we have clicked the cube and let's see, here's the cube. Here are the options from where in the left hand corner, on the topmost corner, we have a move tool. You need to click over here and see the arrows on three dimensions, like the topmost arrow is the Y axis. This one is the X axis. This one is the Z axis. We need to drag the Y axis so that it comes on the top. And now let's click on play and test if it's working. Wait a minute. Just we need to set the camera. Yeah, camera. The thing which I'm doing is not required for your device. As I have set a different webcam for my laptop, I need to do this. Okay, now we have to click on this and wait a minute. And see, now my face has been shown and we have to place the card over here. You can see a simple cube. Firstly, a simple cube is shown on the card. Whenever the camera detects a card, a cube is shown. The cube which we have added as a 3D object on top of the card. So this is the first augmented reality demo which I gave to all of you. The cube isn't present in this real world, but we have bought it using augmented reality technology. So now the cube isn't looking that good. So we will replace it with our art. So for that, we need to delete the cube first. The cube over here, we don't need that. We just click on it and just click on delete. So now we need to add art over here. First of all, you have seen there is a card over here which I've used in order to detect the detect all the points. It's a very colorful card, so I've used it. But this means if we add art over here, it won't make any sense. Like an art over a card, it won't make any sense. So let's change the image of this card and make it like the image of a galaxy. So first we will click on image target, the image target which we have selected. We will click on image target, right click on it. After right clicking, we have 3D objects and we will select plane. We have many options, cube, which we have used just now, sphere, capsule, cylinder, plane, many things, but we will use plane as and we will resize it according to the size of the card. So for resizing, on the left corner we have this option which is used to resize on the left side or top corner. It's a rect tool, and with this we can resize the size of the plane and set it equal to the card, exactly similar to the card. And you can see both of them are merging together. So half of the image of the card can be seen and half of the image of the plane can be seen. So we need to drag it a little bit on the top. So we will select on the plane again. And over here, as I've shown, the move tool. We will select the move tool and drag a slight on the top so that we can see the image clearly. We will minimize it. And I have already taken one picture from Google. That's the picture of the universe. This is the picture which we are going to import inside the plane. So we will just click on the image, drag over here and drop it. See, the image has been imported inside the asset folder. And again, we will click on it, drag over here, and we will drop it on the plane. See, the plane's color, the image of the plane has changed. Now it's, we can see that it's the image of the universe. So now we'll resize it a little bit more and let's play and see what happens. Now when we bring the card, see, the image of the universe is being shown. The card vanishes and the image of the universe is being shown. Now that's not all. We need to add the globe on top of it. So we will again go to asset store from where we downloaded the Vuforia engine. All the 3D assets we can get from here. Anything else, we can also download any VFX, FBX file, FBX.FBX files are the 3D assets which we need to download for Unity. We can download it from Google also, but this is the most accessible place from where we can download. So we go to asset store. Over here we search for art. And these are all paid versions, $14, $4, which we don't require. We need a free one. And this is the one which is free, Planet Art Free. We just need to click on it. So this is also the one which I have downloaded before. So we don't need to download it once more. We just need to import it. There is the file size of this application is 20, of this 3D object is 26.7 MB. Which is quite small. So we just need to click on download first if you haven't downloaded it before, and then we will see this import button. We will click on import and then import it. So the file is imported and we go back to the scenes. We see that in the left hand side corner, we have another folder which has opened like this, Planet Earth Free. You can see it over here also, Planet Earth Free. This folder, we will click on it and we have the models. The model which we are going to implement on this card. So we will click on the models folder. We have three blank models over here. Just the structure. We will bring it over here and place it. Now you can't locate it as it's very big in size. We have to resize it. So first, you can also drag and drop it here. You can also drag and drop it over here in the hierarchy. Anything you can do, you can drag and drop it on the hierarchy or in the scene folder. So just firstly, we need to see the positions where the AR camera is placed or the image target is placed. We click on image target And over here, the transform position is 0, 0, 0. But in case of the planet, we see it's minus 16, 3.4, random position. So we need to change it and make it 0, 0, and the z-axis also in 0. So it will come exactly on top of the card. But the card is quite small, so we need to resize the size of the Earth. So there is a size tool over here, just a 3D size tool. It's a scaling tool. We will click on it on the left-hand side corner. The fourth option from the left-hand side corner is a scaling tool. We just need to click on the white button and just resize it. Resize it again. We have to make it the child of the image target as usual. We have made the plane also the child of the image target. And we will drag it a little bit and position it just on top. Like this. It's still a little big, so we need to resize it a little more. This is the perfect size, according to me. So now the globe is placed, but the globe doesn't have any texture since it's a blank 3D object. So we need to add texture. For that, we again need to go to the folder, Planet Earth folder. Now we have added the model from this folder. Now we have to go to the materials folder. Inside the materials folder, you can see images of Earth. We have to select any of the three images, anyone. I will select the first one and drag and drop it on the Earth. Just from here, we select it, drag over here and drop it. So the Earth got all its textures over here. Now we will play the button and see if the Earth is being visualized or not. Let's see. Yes, we can see the Earth over here on top of the card. The universe is also being shown over here and the Earth. But we know the Earth doesn't stay stable, it rotates. So we need to add a single line of code which will make the Earth rotate. This is the first introduction of C# to you. Means in this Unity folder, we can use two type of languages. One is JavaScript and one is C#. JavaScript is not always possible, means it doesn't help in all of the tasks. There are certain limitations in JavaScript, so we use C# language. So we will click on the 3D object, means the Earth, which we are going to rotate. If we want to rotate the plane, we will click on it. But we want to rotate the 3D object, the Earth. So we will click on it, and on the right hand side, in the inspector window, on the right hand side, below corner, there is an option known as add component. This add component allows us to add many things, like rigid body. Rigid body helps to add gravity on it and many things. But we just need to add a rotation script. So we will go below, and there is an option known as new script. There is a little option in the at the last. It's known as new script. We will click on it, and we will name the script as rotation script. Remember one thing: we never put a space over here. This will create a problem. See, the script name may only consist A to Z. Capital A to Z, 0 to 9. No spaces, no asterisks, nothing. Only the name without any space. So then we click on create an add, and it takes just a few minutes to build the script. And after you have built, you will see that yes, it's built. Rotation script over here. Rotation script. You click on the script and see the script over here. You just double click on it, and we need to start coding over here. The basics of coding, we all know basics of coding as we are all computer science students. So there is nothing different in C#. It's just like C and C++. Everything is similar. So these are the packages which are pre-built in Unity Engine, collection of generics and collection. This first package using system.collection helps to collect all the 3D objects over here. Predefined over here. Then system collection generics are not needed. We can delete it, but we will leave it as usual. But it's mainly needed when we develop a game. And Unity Engine, this one is a must. as it connects, this helps to connect the Visual Studio with the Unity software. This is a must. Then we have public class and the name of the script. MonoBehavior is a predefined class, which is inbuilt inside the script. The void start over here, the void start helps in starting the program, in running the program. So it's a predefined function, which we need to keep. We don't delete it, but, and the update, void update over here, changes all the stuff after the start button is clicked, or when the project starts, the update starts working after that. Each frame, it takes one, it is called once frame, means you know that we have frame drops, frame rates in our devices, like 20 frames per second, 60 FPS, 60 frames per second. All the frames, there will be a change. While we rotate the Earth, it will take all individual frames at once. So the frame drops, frame changes, anything movable things, all will be updated inside the void update section. So firstly, we need to call a float value, which will be like float speed. And we will keep it as 50.0f. So as we use semicolon in every coding language, we will also have to use it over here. Float variable is a variable which stores decimal values. We can store decimal values, means we can like do it like 1, 2, 3, 4, anything. But we will keep it as 0. 50 is a good speed with which it will rotate the Earth. Then after that, in the void update section, we will have to add a code that will make the globe rotate. For that, we have to write transform dot rotate. This function transform dot rotate is called in order to rotate something which is in 3D. And how we will make sure that it's a 3D model, we will write vector, VECTOR 3. Vector 3 means vector 3D, and vector 2 means vector 2D. We are working on vector 3 as we have a 3D model over there, and we will we will select vector 3, and then we will click on dot up. This connects with the Y axis. Let me show you clearly. Transform dot rotate is the function which will help in rotating the subject which we have selected. Vector 3 is for 3D objects. Up is for the Y axis. And we will multiply it with the speed which we have added on top, that is 50. We have set a variable with the name speed over here. You can see speed is 50. So we can call it over here like speed, and then we will multiply it with frame rate. In order to multiply it with frame rate, we just need to write time, T in capital, then dot delta time, delta T-I-M-E, and that's it. This is the code which will make the globe rotate. Transform.rotate is the helps in rotating the function. Up over here is the Y axis which we are accessing. And vector 3 is for 3D model, speed which we have set before, and time dot delta time is the frame rates that will take. And we always need to add a semicolon after completing our statement, and we have to save it. Now for saving, we need control save, and after saving we minimize it and see it's loading. Something is loading. The script is being uploaded to the 3D object. And after that, we will play. Click on play. And see, the globe starts rotating as it does in the real Unity. So we have successfully built one augmented reality project within just 30 minutes. And this is it. The script which I wrote over here, you have seen the transform. Let me show you where the transform actually is. Means we have used transform, but where it is. This is the transform over here. The position, -1, 2.9838, something like that. We are changing the position. This is the transform which we are calling over here, same transform. Then we are making it rotate, and the vector 3 which I have mentioned over here is this one. This is the vector 3 portal, the 3D portal, x axis, z axis, y axis. This is the vector 3 portal. The vector up is the y axis over here, which on the this axis, this is the axis which I have added, and on which the earth rotates. We have added the speed, and this is the frame rate. So that's all for today. The next tomorrow we will learn how to turn this into a application. It takes a little bit of time to turn it into an application. After turning it into an application, we will go and see how we can make a virtual reality application. That's a VR application. We have successfully built one augmented reality application where we can display anything. Like I have displayed a globe. You can display a character, any 3D object on top of this camera. Let me take it. You have to just correctly place the picture in front of the camera. And see, the globe will start rotating. This is our final project for today. So we have successfully built our first augmented reality application. We have to turn it into an APK file and upload it into our mobile phones, which will take a little bit of time. And I will show it to you on the next workshop class. So anyone have any questions? Anyone any doubt? I'm here to clear it. Any doubts related to this session? Anything you may ask me?
There are few questions in the questions box.
Okay.
So you can kindly open the questions box.
Yes. Okay. How much time it takes to download? It depends on your internet speed. Means if you are talking about the Unity, this is Harsh Kumar. I'm talking to you. So if you are using Unity, you're talking about Unity, it's almost a 2GB file. So it takes a lot of time to download. It depends actually on your internet speed. If you have a high speed internet, it won't take a lot of time. Can you please repeat why we need to go to Asset Store? Okay. So this is a Unity folder. Asset store is the place where we get all the 3D objects. Anything, any 3D object we need to download, we get it from the asset store. All the 3D objects, we need a 3D object that is that can be free. We need a 3D object that can be paid. It means like I need a moon object. I have added the globe. I need a moon. I go over here and see there are various 3D objects related to Moon. But these are certain objects are paid, which is $4.9, $30. But if you search for a while, you will see some of them are free. You just need to download the free objects for the initial stage, and then we can go for better objects and we can download or buy objects from there. Okay. Abhishek Mondals, you have asked for a question, but you have just said that, sir, I have a question. You can ask anything. I'm here.
He has written it. If you go down, he has written it. There are few hands raised also. So once you answer the questions which are in the question panel, those hands which are raised, we can unmute them so that they can ask.
What are we going to learn tomorrow? We are going to work on virtual reality tomorrow, and we will learn how we can build an application from this. We have just made it in the software itself. So we will turn into an APK file and run in our own mobile phone. This is what we are going to learn tomorrow. Can you tell again where the code part was done? Okay. So the coding part, nothing fancy. We have to select the object where we need to add the code. Suppose this is the 3D art where we need to add the code. We just select it from the hierarchy or from the scene window. And in the right-hand side corner, in the below part, we have the add comment section, add component section. We just need to click on it, add component. And then we go to new script. New script. If we are adding a new script, we need to click on new script. And we have to give a random name. Random name over here. And just click on enter. And then a script will add. Like the rotation script is added on in the corner. You can see a rotation script is written. Rotation script. This will add over here. This is how we add the script. And on clicking on it, we can click it twice. And the script will open like this. Now you can edit the code and do whatever you want. Okay. Whenever I'm trying to create new project, it's showing me no editor install, but install 9%. Please, you understand me. Whenever I'm trying to create new project, it's showing me no editor install. Okay, no editor install means there is an error in the installation of your 3D of your Unity version. You need to change the version. There are certain problems with the 2019.3 version. You need to change it. That's why I'm using the 2000. You can see which version I'm using. 19.4.3. It is more stable. 19.3, there are certain bugs which the Unity forum is working on. So it's better if you download the 19.4.3 version. That will help. Okay, you have installed. That isn't working. Abhishek, I would like Animesh. Sorry, Animesh. I would. This is Animesh. I already installed. Can you once more show the download option from the Unity? Okay, sure. Firstly, we go to Google. We download the Unity Hub. As I have told you, you have to write Unity Hub. Then after downloading Unity Hub, we just open the software. And here we have the installation process installed. We see on the right hand side, firstly, we have to sign in. We have to give our email ID and a password to log into this Unity portal. And then we go to the installation option, installs. After that, we click on add. We click on add. Then we select any of the versions which is present over here. Any of the versions like Unity 19.3.15. This is the version present over here. And then we click on next. And on clicking on next, then we have to select certain modules over here. One is Android build support, iOS build support. If you are building for an iOS device, if you're building for Android, you must need this one, this Android build support. Under that, you have to check if both of them are checked. Android SDK as well as NDK and JDK. All of them are required. there's a 2.9 GB file, which is quite big. Then you need Microsoft Visual Studio, where you can write the code. Mac build support, as I sometimes make applications for Mac. And when I make applications for Windows, I use this IL2 CPP. So these are the things which you need to check. And documentation is a must. If you don't click on documentation, then the uploads, then the upgradations of the software will not happen automatically, which you have to do it on your own. That's a pretty difficult task. So after that, we need to click on next, and the thing will download. So do we need to pay for Vuforia registration? No. Vuforia is completely free. You just need to go over here and log, register over here. Nothing is paid. Everything I've showed over here is completely free. You can do it. Vuforia can be used 1,000 times. First 1,000 times, it's free. After that, you need to pay. So 1,000 times is a long time. Thousands of uploads of images can be done. So there's no problem in doing that. 1,000 is quite a great time. I have been working for 2 years and I have uploaded just 150 images till now. So 1,000 is a great amount of uploads which you can do. So I have answered all the questions in the question box. You can now bring on the questions from the chat.
So anybody who has few hands were raised, those have been brought down now, because the hands raised were those which you have already answered. So one hand is raised. Abhishek Mandal, he still has his hand raised.
Okay.
And I saw another hand raised, but again it is now lowered. So if you want to ask questions, you may kindly raise your hand. So Abhishek Mandal, I have muted. I have, okay, Muhammad Farhan Arshad. I think I will firstly unmute Muhammad Farhan Arshad, because Abhishek Mandal, you have your answers, questions were answered initially. So Muhammad Farhan Arshad, I firstly, I have unmuted you. Abhishek, I will unmute you after that. So Farhan, you can kindly unmute yourself and talk. Yeah, you can.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Bhaiya, actually, I want to ask that if I have created a project in PC.
Yes.
With the help of webcam, whichever you are doing. But yes, I want to run it in my Android mobile. So how can I do so?
Yes, exactly, exactly. This is the work I have done today. The work which I have done today is completely based on the PC. So I have told you before that I will show how to build it into an APK file for Android devices or for iOS devices. I will show that to you tomorrow, as it takes a takes at least 15 to 20 minutes, which is a long time. So I will show you the process tomorrow. I will build this app into APK, and you can upload it into your Android device and play with it.
Okay, that means for Android mobile, it has another option.
Yes, you have to go to this file option on the left hand side corner. You can see there is build settings over here. Build settings. Build settings. You click on build settings and see there is Android. We have this for PC and Mac. We have to click on Android. We need to switch the platform, and there are certain settings which we need to change, which I will show you tomorrow. Then we have to just click on build, and the APK file will be built. Anything I will show you. Anything else?
No, that's all.
Thank you for that. Okay, so Abhishek, your hand is lowered. Do you want to ask your question? Kindly raise your hands if you want to do that. Or anybody else? Yes, Abhishek, I am unmuting you. I have unmuted you. You may kindly unmute yourself and talk. Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, I have a question that after that, the targeting the image in the website, I didn't understand the after process.
Sorry, I couldn't get it.
After targeting the image, what I have to do?
Targeting image, targeting the image where? Means inside the Unity software or inside the Vuforia?
Vuforia. After that.
Okay. Let me show you. This is the image which you have to go to this target manager. See over here inside the Vuforia, there is target manager over here. Okay, you click on it and you need to add target. After adding on target.
So
After adding the image, you will see there is a database opened. All the list of the database are being opened over here. See, I have made so many images in the past few years. So all the images are here. Recently, I have added this AR art image. You just need to click on it. Okay. You just need to click on it and tick the button. You can see the small icon of the image over here. See the small icon of the image over here. And you have the check button over here on the left hand side. You just need to click on the check button. And here you have seen the download database. You just need to click on download database. And this database will be downloaded in your PC. Like a folder like this will open in your PC. Okay. Now you need to go to Unity software, minimize it, drag it a little to the right hand side, and just the downloaded database you need to drag and drop over here. Okay, in the free space, you just need to drag and drop over here. The target image will come over here. Okay. Can you get my point? Hello.
Yes, sir.
After getting the image inside the portal, you just need to click on image target, and from there, in the left right hand side, you see the type of image which you are going to select. We will see from here, it will initially be from image, and we have to change it to from database. And there, the below that, we will have the option of AR art, the image which we have just imported. We will click on it, and the image of art will be imported inside. The image of the card which we have used will be imported. Anything else?
Yes, sir. Sir, one more question: that how to make the child?
How to make the child? Oh, acha. How to make the child? So it's nothing fancy. We have to just drag. Means suppose this is the art. We have pulled it out. Means we have to drag it. We have to make it the child of image target. So we have to drag and drop it on image target. This, see, this is the child. We have made the image target the child of AR camera. So we have to drag and drop it on AR camera. Just click, right click, left click, and just drag and drop it on AR camera. We can even unchild it. We will just drag and drop it outside AR camera. It will be in the same line, and it's no more a child. Again, we want to make it a child. We will drag and drop it on AR camera, and it becomes a child. This is the most important part. If you don't make a child, then it will not be visualized on your device.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
There are no more hands raised as I can see. However, if you want to ask more questions, you may kindly raise your hand. Okay, so that we can unmute you. But I don't see any more hands raised as of now. However, I'll just check once more. No more hands raised. So, okay, is there any more questions in the question panel? No more questions. So?
No.
Shreshkam, I don't think there is any other question.
Okay. Animesh Hajra, if he is there, he can ask question. Animesh Hajra.
Actually, Animesh Hajra, he is not. He has not raised his hand.
No, he had many questions, but none of his questions were clear, so I couldn't answer.
Yes, because he was unable to understand. As far as I could understand from his questions, that he was unable to understand. He was asking for maybe some other language to be used or something like that. But he is not here. I'm not finding him anymore. Anyway. So I'm not finding him, so that I can actually unmute.
Okay.
So is it over for the day, Shreshkam?
Yes, sir. We will build the app tomorrow, and we will work on virtual reality tomorrow.
Okay. So looking forward to tomorrow. I request all attendees to join in time, 10 a.m. He will be showing tomorrow that how to build the app. That is, once the app is built, now how to get the APK and install that APK in mobile phone and run it from your mobile phone as an application. So that he will be showing tomorrow, and also the virtual reality application building he will be showing tomorrow. Today he has shown augmented reality application building. So, okay, looking forward to meet you tomorrow at 10 a.m. again. It will again be a wonderful session. Thank you so much. You will get the certificates at the end of the session tomorrow. Today, because it's a recurring session, so tomorrow at the end of the session, the certificates will be auto-generated and sent to your email. Okay, thank you so much. Thanks to all of you. Thank you, Shreyaskam. Thank you for the insightful thing. I learned many things. I will be discussing with you personally when we meet so that I can also build many applications in future. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Shreyaskam, you also need to close from your end because you are an organizer, okay? Good morning to all yet again. So it was a wonderful first day. The first session was interesting, where Mr. Shreyaskam Ghoshal actually told you or actually had shown you practically or demonstrated in front of you that how you can build augmented reality applications. You'll be doing a little bit of revision today, maybe, just to remind you what happened. And he will then show how you can build an application out of it. That is, the APK file needs to be built. Once you build this APK file, then only it can be installed in mobile or computer, or maybe you can run it as an application. So that APK file, how it is built, he will show you. And also he will show you the virtual reality, how virtual reality applications can be built. So we are waiting eagerly for a wonderful session. Attendees have more or less joined. However, still many attendees are joining. I will request Mr. Shreyaskam Ghoshal to take it a little slowly, maybe for the coming 3 to 4 minutes, because attendees are joining. Maybe coming 2 to 3 minutes, you can take it a little bit slowly and then again continue with it. We are looking forward. Thank you so much. Many teachers are also there who have joined and they are wanting to learn it. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. It's all over to you. Thank you.
So last day we learned how to build the application. We have built it for the computer devices, but now we will eventually learn how to convert it into an APK file and run it into our mobile devices. So before that, let's take a quick recap of what we have done last day. So this is the Unity software which we opened.
Your voice is getting a little bit feeble, huh? Please take care of it. Maybe you need to hold the
Is it okay now, sir?
Yes, it is okay. Okay, yeah, okay. Now it is fine. Okay.
So this was the application which we built last day, a augmented reality arts application. We'll click on it. Yes, so this was the application. Whenever we click on the play button over here and place our card in front of the camera, we could see the art rotating on the tips of our finger. This was the application we've built last day. So a quick recap of how we made it. So firstly, in the hierarchy, we used to have the main camera section, the main camera where we which we were going to replace with the AR camera. In order to do that, we went to the asset stores over here on top, the section where the asset store is written. If someone asked me that they were facing a problem that they couldn't find asset store over there. So if you cannot find asset store over here, you just need to go to this place, Windows. You can see on top file, edit, assets, game object, component, and window. You click on window and then see you have asset store over here.
or even you can write a shortcut key Ctrl+9, and on clicking that, this asset store window will open automatically. Okay, then we go on the search button over here and type there Vuforia engine. That is the SDK we are going to download and import for our augmented reality camera to come over here. So we click on the Vuforia engine, and the first link that pops up, we will click on that. And if you have already downloaded, you will see this, that there will be a button that will call import. And if you are doing it for the first time, download will be written over here instead of import. Then we will click on the import button, and the Vuforia camera will be imported inside this. Vuforia engine will be imported. And from then, we can go to the components on top of that component over here. To click on component, we just go below. We can see AR is added over here, so we can confirm that augmented reality is present. After that, we will go to game object. Just on top, everything is happening on top. Game object, windows, and a component, all of them are on the top list. So we will click on game object. We will go to Vuforia engine, the thing which we just imported, and then we'll click on the AR camera over here. And on clicking, the AR camera will appear on here. When we click on it, we will see the camera preview, which is blank now, and when we play the video, we will see the it in the form of a camera. Okay, after that, we just need to add a license key to the AR camera, which is very important. If you don't add a license key, it won't work. So on clicking AR camera, on the right hand side corner, there is something written like open Vuforia configuration. Open Vuforia engine configuration. In some of your devices, it will be written like open Vuforia configuration. Just click on it, and we have to add a license key over here. App license key. This license key, from where will we generate? We will generate it from Vuforia engine. We will go to Google. We will type in Vuforia, and the Vuforia developer portal will open over here. Just click on it. If you are doing it for the first time, then we need to register our account over here on the right hand corner. If you are doing it for the second time or more than once you have done already, just click on login, and you can simply join in your account. After that, in order to develop a license key, we just need to click on the get development key. We add a random license name over here, anything like that, ABC can also do. Then by checking this box, we confirm all the requirements, and by confirming, a license key will automatically be generated, and it will be listed over here, ABC AR Earth, the application which we built yesterday. We will click on ABC, and that's the license key over here. We just need to click on it, and the license key will be copied. After that, we go to Unity software, and we just need to copy and paste the license key over here. That's it. The license key is added. Now we need to add the target image. Means at first you saw that whenever I'm holding the card in my hand, then the object is displayed on it. So the card is the target image where the object is being projected. So we just click on AR camera and right click on it. After clicking right on it, we will see there are 3D objects which we can add. So in case of 3D object, we can add a plane that will act as a 3D platform where we can add the picture of this universe. And doing that, we just need to go to component section. Sorry, we just need to go to this game object section, and then Vuforia engines and target image. And after setting the target image, after selecting the target image, as we have already
Hello. Hello. Are you there, Mr. Shreshkam? Are you there? Participants, kindly wait. Maybe there is some internet connection problem over there. I'll just get in touch with him in a minute. I'll just get in touch with him.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
You can listen. Yes, you're audible. Again, you're audible, but maybe your internet connection, there was some problem.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It was lost for some reason.
Okay, so.
Is the screen visible properly?
Yes, yes. Screen is visible, but it is showing, sorry, service is temporarily unavailable, something like that. It is showing.
Yes, yes. Yes, it will be resolved.
Yeah, you can refresh it.
Yes, so in the target manager, we need to go to the target manager where we will select the image. And from there, we will add the database over here. On the right hand side corner, there is add database option. You click on it, select the device, and then name a random thing. Let it be the same as the previous one, ABC. Create one. And on creating that, we will get it listed on the database list over here. All the lists are over there, and you will see that ABC is listed also. We just need to click on this ABC, and we need to add a target image. We click on add target image or add image. As we are walking on a 2D plane or a 2D object, that's the card. So we will click on the single image option. We will make the width of it as 5. You can also make it 3, 4, but not more than that. Then browse it from your desktop. Click on any of the random images over here, which you want, on which you want to target the 3D objects, and then just add the database. After adding, as you saw last day, we just need to make sure that the image has a good quality. Means this was the image which we imported last day, and it has a rating of 5-star. We need to make sure that all the images that we import over here needs to have a rating of minimum 3-star. Anything below that won't be acceptable, as it would you would face a problem while detecting it. So after that, we need to click on download database. See, download database over here. We just need to check the button over here. There is a small button on target image, and this button, we need to check it. A tick will be shown, and then you go to download database, and the database will be downloaded. After all the procedures are done, you will get a file like this. A file like this. I'm showing it in the center of my desktop. This file will be downloaded. You need to drag and drop this file inside your Windows, inside your Unity software, and the target image will be imported inside the Unity software. Then you go to the target image on the hierarchy. You just click on it, and from there, that we have to change the type of image from database. We have to make it from image to from database. After that, we have to go to the earth. We have to select which image we are going to select for this. So we will click on this, and you will see automatically the name popping up over here, AR Earth, which we have selected last day. After selecting that, you will be able to see the image over here. That is the image of the card. And then if you want to add like the Earth model, we will go to the asset store, and from there we will search the Earth model, and we will go for the free models over here, because there are a lot of free models which are present. We don't need to pay anything. We just go for here, the asset which we have already downloaded. We go a little below where the download button is written, import button is written. We click on it, and the 3D model will be imported. After importing, we just need to drag and drop it from this asset scene. It will be imported over here. We just need to drag and drop it inside the image folder and make it a child of it. Inside the image target and make it a child of it. Just drag and drop it on top of the object and it will become a child. After that, that is the main part of making anything into, or converting anything into augmented reality. But if you want to add some sort of codes over here, we just need to click on the object on which the code needs to be applied. We just click on it. And over here on the left hand, right hand side corner, below on the right hand side corner, we have add component section. We click on add component from their new script, add component, new script, and we give a random name of the script. Last day, we gave it as rotation. We just need to type out whatever name we want to call it. After giving that name, we have to make sure one thing that there is no space between the names. Like I have written, suppose I have written rotation space script. This won't work. We need to maintain this. We need to avoid any spacing between all of them. And then just click on create an ad. On clicking on creating an ad, a script like this rotation script, this will be added inside the game object, that is the Earth. We will double click on it. It will open Visual Studio. And up from there, we can start coding for our game or for our augmented reality application. I just did two things last day. We added a speed of rotation to the object, that is 50, and we made it a float value so that we can change it in form of decimals. You can also implement it in integer value if you want, but I prefer it to be done in float value. So I have made or set the speed of the object. Then in the void update section, where it changes frame by frame, we all know about frames, what happens in FPS, frames per second. So this is the thing which changes frames by frames. So I have made one code. I have written transform.rotate, means transform section. I will show you where the transform section is in the inside the Unity folder. This is the transform section. When we select the globe on the right hand side, this is the transform section. That is the position of the globe. We need to change the position only. Then transform.rotate. Transform.rotate over here means the position will rotate. On the basis of which will it rotate, that we have to set. So we have set that vector.up. Vector.up means the y-axis. This is the code language for y-axis, vector.up. Vector.up, on setting it, it will rotate on the y-axis. And then we are setting the speed or multiplying the speed with it. That is the 50F, which we have stored as a variable on top of it. And then time.delta time is the frame rate which we are deciding it. This is a predefined value over here, time dot delta time. You just need to type it. Make sure the time in the first place is the T is capital, then delta in small, then again T in capital for the time. If you write anything wrong over here, it won't work. And always make sure that you have put a semicolon after that, all the sentence. So after setting this code, we just need to save it. And finally, the code will be implemented on this Unity software, and the Earth will start rotating. So this was all we have done yesterday. This was a small recap of all the things we have done yesterday. Now, the important thing, we have made it, we have converted it into an app, but we need to make it in, transform it into an APK file. Or for iOS devices, we need to also start transfer it for into an APK file. For that, we need to do some settings. For that, we need to change some settings. So we will go on the left hand side top corner, the file section. From there, there is a build settings. We will click on build settings, and this window will pop up. As you can see, there is a window which is popping up. Initially, it will be selected like this: PC, Mac, and Linux. The topmost part in this list, and you will click on this Android part. On clicking on Android part, here you can see I have a build section. Instead of that, you will get a switch platform. Suppose I am doing it for iOS. I will click on iOS. See, there is a switch platform coming over here. At the end, there is a switch platform section. Means we are changing the platform. I have already transformed it into an APK as it takes a lot of time. So I have already transformed it into an APK file. So it's no more showing me switch platform. But when you are doing it for the first time, there it will be shown the switch platform. You just click on it and wait for 2 minutes. The platform will switch. Then you go, you will see here one option is there, player settings. You will click on it. There is an option on the left hand side corner of this pop up window. You will see, and that's the player settings section. You just click on it and this window opens. Here you need to make some certain changes. Okay, so in your case, you will see the company name. On top of it, there is company name. First section is company name. Over there, it will be written default company. You need to change the name and make it a company of your own. I have renamed it and made it default AR. You can change it to your name also. It doesn't matter. But you need to change the initial name, which is default company. Then the product name. The name of my product is AR Earth. You have to change the name to AR Earth. Then set any random version. If you are doing it for the first time, set it to 1.1. I have done it many a time, so I have changed it to 10.1. After that, you just scroll down a little bit, and over here you will see the other settings option. Okay, before that, if you want to set an icon for your device, for your application, you just click on the icon button over here. On the second list, you have icon. You just click on it. Okay, you just click on the icon button. You will see there are so many icon section opening over here. A blank box will open on the right hand side for background, foreground images. You don't need to change all of them. You just need to change the first one. That's the icon. You just click on it, and here you will see a very small select option. If you have any 2D image, you just need to select it and add the image from there to here. You just need to select the image from the left hand side corner. There is a selection option. You just need to click on select. You add the image from here, and your icon will be set. After adding the icon, you need to change one more setting. We have to go to publishing settings. Publishing settings is mainly required when you upload your app in your Google Play Store. It's very important. You just need to click on publishing settings, and here you will see many settings are unticked. So make sure you just tick the base Gradle template. There is one option, custom base Gradle. I would suggest you to write it down. There is one option, custom base Gradle template. This will only if you want to upload this into Play Store, not now. If you are initially making this application into an APK file, you don't need to click on it. But whenever you are uploading it for Play Store, you need to make sure this checkbox is ticked. Otherwise, you won't get a privacy policy from the Play Store and it won't be uploaded. Then go to other settings. Then go to other settings. And over here, you have to make a lot of changes. Firstly, there is an identification section inside other settings, package name. You have to change the package name. Initially, it will be com.something default.company name. You have to change it to com.yourcompanyname. Dot your application name or product name. In my case, my company name is default AR, so com.defaultAR dot the company name dot the product name. In my case the name of the product is AR Earth, so com.defaultAR.ARearth. This is the package name which you have to set, and make sure everything present over here is in small letters. You can't use capital letter over here. After that, you have seen we have updates in WhatsApp. So in update, you will see update 2.0, 2.1, 2.3. So that's the version of WhatsApp we are using, or any application we are using. You have versions, different versions. So you need to set a version over here. when you update it in the Play Store, you have to change the version again. It's initially 10.1. You can in the next update, you can change it to 10.2, 10.3, and so on. Rest settings will be automatically the same. Just you have to set the minimum API level, the API level which is required for minimum application building, to Android KitKat. You will see a lot of options: Android Pie, Oreo, Nougat, Marshmallow, Lollipop, everything. You need to set it to Android KitKat 4.0, API level 19. This is the base Android, so that even a mobile which is not so high end, which is at least make it at least 5 years old, it can also run your device. So make it 4.4 KitKat, Android 4.4 KitKat. And these are the changes which you need to make, nothing else. These are the basic changes which you need to make. And after changing all these settings, just close this window. Go to build option. You will see a small build option on the pop-up menu. This is the pop-up menu. Below that, you will see the build option. You just click on it and wait for at least 5 to 10 minutes. You have to wait a long time, as the APK needs to be built, and the APK building takes a little bit of time. After that, an APK file like this. This is the APK file. It will be produced after 10 minutes. Max to max, it will take 10 minutes. You can just plug in your USB cord and transform this APK file into your mobile phone. And on transferring, then install the APK file. And after installing, you will see the device, see the application in your mobile phone. So I would like to show you how it works. I don't know if my phone screen can be shared. Can we access?
Yes, okay. Kindly click on the line. It can be shared. You can kindly click on the link.
Yes, sir.
You have entered through the link.
No, sir. Sir, wait for a minute.
Okay.
I have uploaded the application in a different phone. So.
Okay, you kindly click on the link and do it, no problems. I'm sure the participants are enjoying this. In the meantime, you could, Shreshkam, you kindly can tell your email ID so that people can connect with you, or any other mode of connection.
So you can contact me via Facebook. The link is shared in Facebook. You will see my name. Other than that, you can have my email ID, that is shreyashkamghoshal@gmail.com. shreyashkamghoshal@gmail.com. I will repeat it once again. shreyashkamghoshal@gmail.com. At the end of the session, I will write it in the in a Word file so that you can see it if there is any problem.
I have sent it via chat to everybody. You may kindly check it.
So I'm joining with a different email ID.
Okay. No problems. You can join with the same email ID also, but kindly join through the phone.
Yes, I'm joining through the phone only.
So this is the email ID. I just shared my screen. You can see the email ID of Mr. Shreyashkam Ghoshal. Shreyashkam, is this correct? Kindly have a look at the email ID.
Yes, sir. Absolutely correct.
Okay, so this is the email ID where you can contact him. Have you joined from your phone?
Sir, I'm trying to join. I have sent the request. Join webinar in progress.
Okay, no problems. In your email ID, you have an H, S-H-R-E-Y-S.
Yes, sir.
You have
it, na? Yes, sir.
Okay. So in the meantime, he is trying to join through his phone because he wants to share the phone, share the contents of the phone so that you can understand how the APK file after being loaded to the phone, how it looks like. So he's trying to join through phone. Once he joins, we can share his phone screen also.
Just a minute, the software is being downloaded.
Okay.
While you install the APK file inside your phone, there some warnings will show, like a security scan warning, Play Store warning. As it is not an authorized app, you are building it on your own. So when you try to install this application in your phone, there will be certain warnings will show, like this is, as it is not an authorized app, you have built it on your own, so no company name, no Play Store certification. So there might be some warning shown, so don't fear about that. There is no bugs inside this application. You can run it easily. It won't have any issues with your phone. You just need to install, avoid all the warnings that's shown, and that's all. So I have joined the webinar.
Okay, I'm just trying to find you. Just give 1 minute to me again. Okay, I found you. So you will find a share screen over there in your phone. Do you find that?
Yes, sir. I'm sharing it.
Okay, so now you can see the phone screen. Everybody can see your phone screen.
Okay.
But I believe it is slow because you are doing it from one internet itself. So please adjust accordingly.
Okay, so this I will show you that application. It may be a little slow. Just hang on.
It is a bit slow.
You can see the ARArt application. It's visible here, ARArt application in the last row. And the leftmost corner, ARArt application. This is the application which we built just now. We just need to upload it in our phone and install it. After that, just click on it. And the camera and something like a camera will start. First, it will show the branding Unity. This is the view of the application which you are going to get. And whenever you place the class card in front of it, you will see. It's lagging a lot, but this is what you will see. And it's working absolutely fine. You can try it on your own. The arch is rotating and everything is working fine. But due to internet issues, I think a little bit lagging over there. So that's the application which you have built just now. Try it on your own and let me know if you are able to do it. If you face any problem, just contact me via email and I will make sure I will reply to all of you. So I'm stopping the sharing option from my phone.
Okay, so you want to again share your computer screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I think this was quite understandable. People could understand it, could at least get a feeling of it.
So that's it. We have built our final AR application. Now we will move on to build a VR application. Let me set up a little bit. I just removed my phone from the page. Okay, now we have built the augmented reality application as our first game or first 3D application. Now we will move on to VR. VR is a subject which we are all familiar about. We have once in a lifetime we have used VR, all of us. And even if you haven't, you will be the only one who will make it on your own and use it on your own. So let's get started. We open the Unity software again, the same way we have did it for the augmented reality one. And over here, we start a new project and name it like VR1 application, maybe, and create one. Here there are lots of stuff that needs to be done, means lots of editing, lots of adding of 3D models, designing need to be done, as we have to make a different environment. And when we wear the glass or when we see through the VR application, we can make sure that we are present, we can feel like we are present in a different environment from the place we are sitting on. So this is how it will work. Let's begin. Let's start the project. So this is the same window which we have opened for the AR application, but here a little different will happen. So in case of AR, we have imported the VR Vuforia engine from the asset store. The SDK which we required, we have imported it from the asset store. But for this case, we don't need the Vuforia engine for VR. We need a Google SDK. And the Google SDK, I am providing you the link from where you can download the Google SDK. This is the link. You just note it down. This is the link from where you can download the Google SDK. Or just take a screenshot of it so that it remains in your phone. Okay, I think you have noted down. So now we will go to the application. Here we just need to, as we have done in case of pictures and all, we just need to when you download, you will see a file like this, a Google VR for Unity file over here. After you download, you just need to drag and drop it inside the Unity folder and it will start decompressing, and then we will click on import. And the file or the package will be imported inside the VR application which we are going to build. So this is very important. In case of augmented reality, we need Vuforia engine, but in case of VR applications, we need Google VR application or Google VR for Unity. This is the SDK we need to download from the link which I have provided. It's a GitHub link. You can get it from there and just import it inside the VR application. So after it's imported, you will see Google VR. You will see Google VR here. You can see it. There is Google VR written. You just click on it. You will see many folders open. You will get confused initially what are these folders doing over here, but we don't need to discuss all things about that. We don't need all of the folders, we just need two or three things from this folder. So we will go back to the assets, and there we need to, in case of the AR application, we saw that we made the changes in the player settings at the last of the game. Means we have completed making the software, completed making the application. After that, we changed some settings in case while building the application. But in this case, we have to change it at first. So we will go to the file section over here. We will click on it, build settings, and then first we will switch to Android platform. This is what happens when you click on Android. You will get an option like switch platform. You just click on it, switch platform, and you have to hold on for a while. Some scripts are being compiled, some APIs are being changed, and then it will change into an Android, change and make it compatible for an Android device. These are the settings which are very important. If you miss any of them, it won't work. Okay, now we have converted into an Android application. So now just click on build option over here when you need to build the application. But now we will click on player settings, and we have to change few things over here. Whenever you click on player settings, you just scroll down a little bit, you will see there are two APIs added, one Vulkan API and one OpenGL API. OpenGL API is the suitable one. We don't need the Vulkan API. It is needed when we make a VR application for like Oculus 3D or like Microsoft HoloLens, the bigger devices, the handheld devices, head mounted devices. But we are going to make an application for our phone only, so that it's accessible to all. So we won't use this Vulkan API over here. And if we can keep it, but this might cause a problem after using the application for 3 to 4 times. It will make the application lag. So we need to delete it. We just click on it, and on the left hand side corner, on the right hand side corner, there is a plus sign and the minus sign. The minus sign is for removing the APIs, and the plus sign is for adding the APIs. We need to click on the plus sign, and the API will be removed. The Vulkan API, make sure you don't delete the OpenGL API that's needed for a mobile device. You just need to delete the Vulkan API. Click on it, click on the minus button, and the Vulkan API will be deleted. This may take a few minutes, and thus the Vulkan API is deleted. Now we have to set the device, set our phone's view as a VR view, which is the most important part. We need to scroll down a little. We go down, and there you see an XR setting over here. XR setting, the XR which I told yesterday. XR is extended reality settings. We will click on it, and you will see another pop-up starts up. And there is an option, virtual reality supported, and there is a checkbox beside it. You just need to click on the checkbox inside the XR settings, and then there are virtual reality SDKs which we need to upload over here. So in case of us, we are going to make the application for a mobile device, so we need a Google Cardboard type thing or a slot in which where we can just insert our phone and we can see the VR device. We just need to click on the plus sign over here, the same plus sign which was up there inside the Vulkan API. We just need to click on the plus sign over here, and you will see the options: Cardboard, Daydream, head-mounted devices, Monk, None, Oculus, anything. So we are working for the Cardboard. We will click on the Cardboard device, and it will be imported. These settings are very important. All the settings are very important. If you don't set your application accordingly, it won't work the same way you are expecting it to work. So just make sure you have done all this. Now you can see inside the virtual reality SDKs, the cardboard option has popped up. So this is what we need to set at first. And that's all for the VR settings. We have to close it, and now we will work in the main field. So this is the scene window. Here we will add a plane where we will stand ours. We will make ourselves stand and view all the different angles from there. So click on the hierarchy, right click on the hierarchy, go to 3D objects, and there you will get the plane option. You click on the plane and the plane appears. This is the plane. We need to change the color of the plane as it is blank. Suppose we will add a road or a grass type texture on it. So we will first download the photo. I have already downloaded. You just need to drag and drop it on the assets folder. Just drag and drop. Yes. When you drag and drop, the grass picture comes on the assets folder. From there, you again drag and drop on the plane which you have created in the scene window. You just drag, and yes, the color of the plane changes to a grass. Now we have changed the color of the plane and we have added a texture to it. And now we will add a cube as a reference to the center. We don't know where the center is. When you view it from a different angle, you won't be able to know where the center is. So for that, we will create on the hierarchy 3D object cube, and the cube in the transform window. You will click on cube. On the right hand side, you will see the transform window. We just need to reset the transform. We will click on the three dots over here. We will click on reset, and the cube will center itself. We'll make it in the center. We'll make it in the center position. After making it in the center position, we need to change the color. It is a transparent color which is shown over here, which we will not be able to see at once. So we need to change, or we need to add a material to this. For that, you go on the blank folder, that is the asset folder here. You right click on it. On the first option, you will see create. You click on create, then you go a little bit down, and here is the option of materials. Let me find it first. There is an option called material. Yes, this is the option, material. You click on it, and a structured material or a round structure opens. Here you can change the color texture of the material. When you click on the material up inspector window, there is an option where you can change the color. A white box will appear at the corner, a very small white box. You click on it and change the color to, suppose, red or anything. You can change the color. You will see the color changing. You can change the color to blue, red, black, anything, any of your favorite colors which you want to add. Then after doing that, you just need to click on the material, drag and drop it. You see, if I add the material to the plane, the color of the plane will change, but we won't change the color of the plane. We will change the color of the box. We will drag it to the box, and the color of the box or the cube will change. We reposition it. We drag it a little bit on top, and this is the red box which we have created. This will act as a center point for us, from where we can see all the different angles. This will act as a center point for us. After that, we have added the material. We will bring the camera close. This is the camera view we are getting. There is a main camera over here. In this case, we have the work of main camera. In that VR AR application, we used to have the work with AR camera. But in VR camera, we have the work with main camera. We click on main camera. You can see a small camera preview over here, a very small camera preview. So that's not what we want. We will drag the camera a little bit forward towards the red box. The red box, we will make it as we will consider it ourselves to be the red box. we will stay in the position of the red box. So we can relocate it. We will click on the camera and locate the camera where we want. Let me set it over here. This is a position where the camera needs to be set. Now we have seen whenever we use a VR, as in the direction in which we move our hand, the VR also moves. That's the thing we are going to set now. We have imported the Google SDK inside the asset set. So here is a search button. Here is a white search button over here. We will search emulator over here. EMULATOR. And when we search emulator, a blue box opens up. GVR editor emulator. GVR stands for Google VR. Google VR editor emulator. This is the thing that helps our device to rotate according to the motion of our head. So we will drag this from here in the hierarchy. We have dragged this from the asset section to the hierarchy. And after that, we will create an empty object. We will right click on the hierarchy, create empty. You will see before the 3D object which we are building for the last few times, the plane, the 3D object, the cube, we have a create empty option. We will click on the create empty option and a game object will be created. We will rename it. You can right click on it and rename, or you can see it is also present here in the inspector window. You can rename it from here also. Anything you want. You just click on it and name it as camera rig. Camera rig. Okay. Sorry, I have written the spelling wrong. And yes. See, the empty game object's name changed to camera rig. This will help us to set up the camera. As you see, the position is somewhat different, which this is the set of, this is the position of the game object. We need to change it. So we will do, we will add the main camera and make it a child of this camera rig. You just drag the main camera and make this a child. From the top, you just drag the, I will show it again. Here is the main camera. You just drag it and make it a child of camera rig. After that, you just need to reset the position of the main camera. As the position changes, you have to again reset. We have already changed the position. We have made it perfect for our view. You just need to go click the camera review, camera main camera, and go to transform. In the right hand side corner, you have three dots. You click on reset. And after that, the camera rig and the main camera will have a same position. Both of them have a same position. Now we need to change the position of the camera rig. So we will select the camera rig and go back a little bit, and you will see how it works. We will pull it up a little bit on the left hand side so that the viewing angle becomes perfect. Let's set it perfectly. You can rotate the scene using the hand sign on the left hand corner. On the left hand corner, you have a hand sign on the top of it below the files. You can rotate the scene using this. So you will click on the camera and position it again. Just click it forward, pull it a little bit on the top, little on the right. I will make sure the x axis is zero. And yes, that's the camera view. Now when we play the game, that's what we are going to view. In order to change the view, means you know, in a VR headset, we whenever we move our head accordingly, everything will change. So click on Alt and the left button of your mouse, and you will be able to change the view in all different angles you want. Back view, top view, front view, downwards view, every view you will be able to change. And this will happen same when you will add a head mounted device to it. Okay, we will stop it over here. And now we will add some 2D models, 3D models to this plane, as this is not looking so good. So we will go to the asset store. This is the designing part. I will show a little bit of it. You will have to design it accordingly. Go to the asset store. Here you will get models for animals. We will search for animals, A-N-I-M-A-L-S. And when we search it, you will get many 3D models. These are all the paid ones. I would suggest you to go for the free ones. as there are many 3D models which are free and quite usable. So this is the model which I am going to take. I am sure that all of you have played Minecraft. These are the models from Minecraft, 2D, different retro structure models. These are very low poly models, which won't take a lot of space in your mobile device. So these are the models which we are going to import. We will click on import. In your case, you will click on download, then import. We'll click on import, and then again on import, and the import will happen eventually. The import is done. We need two more things. We have added the models. We need a tree. I think you can use tree if you want. If you don't, then you can leave it. The main thing is we have to change the scene, which we have to change a sky. We have to add a sky for it. The area needs to have a sky. So we will write skybox. And remember this name, skybox. You will click on it. A skybox will be added. Wait, we have to search for it, which skybox you like it. There are many skybox, many environmental scenes which you can add. I will go for this one. This is quite a bit natural. So I will click on it and you will see this is a blue sky, which I can import. I will import it. It's just a 7.3 MB file, which is quite low. These are the two assets we need to import, and this will help in designing your virtual reality world where you will present yourself. Okay. The designing section is completely up to you. You can design it whatever way you want to make it look good. You can also add real life models, like you can add Eiffel Tower, you can add Taj Mahal over here, so that you can have a view on it, and this will be helpful for you as its lockdown is going on everywhere, so we are unable to go to any of the places. So you can add like that and have fun at your home. So after importing, go to the scenes view, and inside the below you will see there are two folders added. One is the Fantasy Skybox and Terrain Auto Upgrade. Terrain Auto Upgrade is not needed, and we have to first add the animals. So this is the asset for the animals. Let's see where that is. Voxel Animals. The asset name is Voxel Animals. You will see over here. We will click on the folder. From there, assets. From assets, we have prefabs. We will not go to the models folder. See, the models and the materials, the texture of the animals, both together combined makes the prefab. So we will directly click on the prefab, and here we have all the 3D models. We will see here we have all the 3D models. We will drag it and drop it into our scene. There's a cat, there's a chicken, a dog, a lion. I don't know how will this chicken and dog survive over here in front of a lion. Anyways, we will add it over here. There are certain structures for trees. We can add it and make the design look more nice. Just drag it a little. Can add it over here. We can add a tree on that corner also. You can change the view using the hand view. Or you can use the vector over here. You can click on the Y axis to see if all of them are added correctly. Here is a vector. You can click on the Z axis, X axis, Y axis. This will change the view so that you can arrange all the things nicely. Let's click on it. This tree is a little bit out of the zone where we want to keep it. This tree also. We'll go on adding more trees to make it look a little bit realistic. So it's not. We can add a bigger tree over here. Okay,
So all of them are added. Now we need to make sure all the y-axis is absolutely perfect. We need to make sure the x-axis. So we will make sure of the x-axis if everything is working perfectly. All the trees are on the plane. None of them are outside the plane. Yes, from all the sides, the trees are inside the plane. But you see one thing. Due to this shadow, you will be unable to view what is over here. So we need to add a light over here. First, click on the directional light, which is already present in the hierarchy. You click on the directional light. One light is already present, and this is in this direction. You can see it's in a slanting position. This is in this direction. We will copy it. Control C, Control V. We will make it a duplicate. And this duplicate, we will change the direction of this. We will rotate it. We will rotate the position from this to 90 degree, or even it was 50, let's make it 150. We will rotate it in this direction, and we will position it a little bit so that we can add light from this direction also. One light is added from this direction, so we need to add light from a different angle also. Now we will click on play. You will see there is a little bit darkness all over there, so we need to adjust it a little more. We need to drag it in, make sure that all of the lights are working perfectly. Just make the design look pretty good so that you enjoy it when you play with it. You can add more lights. You can copy Control V, Control C. You can add more lights like this. You can add another light over here. This is the way you can design your platform. Anything you can do with it. See, now it's quite a bit light present over here, and you can view all the things, I think. So this is the red box which is making the issue. We will delete it. We will click on the box which we have added previously and delete. Now you will be able to see all the 3D objects present beside you. So these are the 3D models, the lion, the cat, the chicken, the trees. The sky doesn't look good. This is not the actual sky which we are wanting. So we will change it. In order to change it, you go to the Windows section. We need to go to the Windows, then rendering. Make sure this Windows rendering, then light settings. Windows rendering, light settings. You click on the light settings. Here you have a skybox material option. Skybox material. You click on it, and you have many options for the sky. The asset which you have just imported is shown over here. I will make it a little bigger. There are so many options for the sky which you can add, but these are not all sky. All the 3D materials are over here. These are not the skies. You will have to search for it and see sunny one, sunny two, like that, night one, night two. We need a sunny sky, so we will click on it and see the skybox changes. Wait, see the sky color of the sky changes. It was default like this, and we have to change it into a skybox, sunny sky. And now whenever you play on it, you will see the color of the sky will change. See, there is something added on the sky. Clouds are added, sun is added, and this looks pretty good. And in when you are having a VR view, see the animals are also moving a little bit, as they have already added some sort of animations to it. The tail of the cat is moving, the head is like hopping here, the lion, I don't know why he is shivering. Maybe he has fever. Anyways, okay, so these are the models which we have added, and the skybox. This is pretty much the thing which we need to do in case of designing. And so the structure of the 3D VR is built. Now you will say, so this is a single view. In case of VR, we have dual view. Means we have a view on the left hand side, and we have a view on the right hand side for both of our eyes. So this won't happen over here. For this, you have to go to File and build it into an APK. Just go to Build Settings,
we have already changed the settings. You can again go to the player settings and make sure that the API level that is in the other settings, you have to make sure the API level means that that Vulkan value is not here. We don't need to set the Vulkan value, and then you just need to build the application. Click on build and the application, this a folder like this will open. You just rename it, anything you name it as VR1 and save in your desktop folder. You will name it as VR1 and save it. It will automatically change into a dual view. You are seeing it as a single view over here, but when you build the application, it will automatically change into a dual view due to the GVR editor emulator which we have added, which we have just dragged from the assets and added it in the direction in the hierarchy. Due to that, it will change into a dual view. And also we have changed the setting. You will remember in the player settings we have made the Google Cardboard, we have transferred it into a Google Cardboard. The virtual reality support, we have checked the virtual reality support, and from there we have transferred it into a Google Cardboard. So whenever the app is built, it will be built for a Google Cardboard. So let the app build. It takes a lot of time. So I have already made the application yesterday. I will show. I would like to show you that application. Sir, would you please allow me to share the screen of my phone?
Yes, I will do that. Just a minute, please.
So I think I have left the meeting.
Yeah, you left that. That's why I was not finding you. Okay. So sorry, you can kindly join.
Yes, please. So I'm joining.
Sure. Okay, I found you.
Yes.
See, you will find that share your screen option on the phone.
Yes. Yes. So I think the screen is visible.
No. Yeah. Now it is visible.
Yeah. Yes. So I have built the application already. See, there is an application in the last row. Its name is VR app. In the last row, the AR Earth application, and beside that, the VR app application. We will just click on it. And you will see a Unity section over there. See, you can see the view has changed into a dual view, which is similar to the Google Cardboard we use, or whenever we use a 360 video. This was a view which I built last night. Exactly the same. I have just added a different kind of trees over here. You just need to rotate the device and it will show. This is the VR application. You just need to move it a little and everything will work fine. So I would request you to change my screen sharing to my desktop. I would like to show it in a different way because it's lagging over here and they won't understand it very easily. I will show it in
the desktop. I'm doing the net full.
Okay, so is my screen visible?
Yes, it is.
Okay, okay. I will show you it in a different way. I will do one thing. I will open the previous VR application. This VR one application. No, the AR application which I built last. Inside the application, we will play the camera. Okay. So now I will show you how it works. Whenever you rotate the camera in which direction, in every direction you want, see, the VR device is also rotating. Look forward. Look upward, look downward, anything. The direction in which, whichever direction you move your head after wearing the head devices, you will see the view. So that's what our VR application looks like, our first VR application. So we have successfully built one VR application and one AR application. I think it's visible clearly now how it works. Okay. That's it.
Hello, sir.
Hello. Yeah.
Yes,
I
sir.
Was just so, muted and I was trying to talk. Yeah, tell me.
Okay. So everything is done. So both of the applications are built. Now I would like the participants to ask some questions if they have any doubt.
Yeah, you can read the questions yourself. Just the questions panel. I think it's better that you read it yourself because you can take the questions as per your. Maybe the chronology, that will be better. So do you find the questions panel? You can click on it.
Yes, sir. Okay, so all of you, good morning. You have said good morning a lot of time. Okay. Do we need to have complete C-sharp knowledge? Yes, C-sharp knowledge is a must. Means whenever we need to get into the coding part, we have to have a C-sharp knowledge. Or even you can have JavaScript knowledge if you know JavaScript already. So C-sharp knowledge is a must, but even if you know JavaScript, you can code. But in case of JavaScript, there are certain problems. You can't access all the APIs using JavaScript. So C-sharp is a better option for me. Okay. Then. Arijit Goswami, I couldn't answer understand your question. As it usually shows, we have to click install all anyways. For what are you talking about? Make sure you ask the question properly again. So it's working absolutely fine. Okay. How to add a picture into the card? Okay, in case of the VR AR application you're talking about. In order to add a picture, I just showed you. You just need to open the AR application, go to image target, and then after that, here from the database, you have to change the type of database. You have to click on from database, from image, it will be initially selected from image. You have to click on from database. Okay. And from there, you can select the images. How to integrate AR and VR. Means how to merge, is this question, Prakhar Kumar, is this question like how to merge AR and VR? Can you ask the question once more? Prakhar Kumar, in case of AR application.
Sure, it is how to merge AR and VR.
Yes, so we can merge AR and VR. We just need to, suppose in this case, we have made this augmented reality application. We just need to add the Google API. Google SDK, which I showed in case of that VR application. This is the SDK over here. We just need to drag and drop it inside the assets folder. And then we have to go to file, build settings, delete the Vulkan value and just transform the XR settings and add the Google Cardboard over there. And just like that, the VR view will change. And make sure you add the Google VR Editor Emulator, GVR Editor Emulator, from this assets folder and drag it in the hierarchy. This is all the works we need to make a VR. In case of AR application, please repeat the final step of converting. Is there any app for Unity Hub? I mean, can we do all the process in our phone? No, you can't do all the process in your phone. Unity Hub is a big software, like 2 to 3 GB software. So you need to have a laptop or a desktop where you need to download this Unity Hub, and you need to have a RAM of at least 8 GB, because it's a 3D software. All the works inside this are done in 3D. So it's if you have a 4 GB RAM in your device, it won't work so nicely. You will have rendering issues and all. So you need to change it. Vuforia is... No, Vuforia is not an alternate to Wikitude. Wikitude is for Gadot. You need Vuforia is a different thing. Vuforia is for different purpose. It's not an alternate to Wikitude.
Mr. Shreyaskam, I just request you, if you can kindly read out the questions, because other people are not able to see the questions. If you can read the questions and then answer, it will be better, kindly.
Okay, this is a question from Prakar Kumar. Vuforia is Vuforia an alternate to Wikitude, or they are different in process? So Wikitude is not used as Vuforia. Wikitude is used for Gadot. Gadot is a different software, and Vuforia is used for Unity. You can also install Vuforia in Gadot, but it won't help. They are different. Okay. Can you please repeat the final step once again? Final step in the augmented reality application. Ankit Shah, can you please mention from where do I need to repeat the final step? Okay, the augmented reality application. In the augmented reality or virtual reality? Let me know. Ankit Shah, augmented reality or virtual reality? AR. Okay. So go to files. Let me show you again. Go to files, build settings, player settings. And there you need to change the company name, product name, and version name. These are the three main things which you need to do inside the player settings: company name, product name, version name. Then go to other settings. Here also, we need to change the version name and package name. Make sure the package name is com dot the company name you have set above. In my case, it's default AR dot the product name, that is AR Earth. After that, there is a version. You will set the same version which you have set above. And then change the minimum API level to Android 4.4 KitKat. Android 4.4 KitKat. And then just close it. And build setting. Go to build settings and build, and the APK will be built. And other question: is there any app for Unity Hub? I mean, can we do the process in our phone? Shrestha Mukherjee, no, there isn't any app for Unity Hub inside our phone, so we need to install it in our PC only or in our laptop. Merge AR VR again slowly. I don't get it. Okay, merging AR VR, it will take a lot of time, but I will try to show you in a short time. Like in my case, this is the AR application. You just need to add this Google SDK which I showed you. You just need to drag it and drop it inside the asset store. That's all. And then you go to file settings, build settings. Inside that, player settings. Inside the player settings, you go a little down. Here you have the XR settings, the extended reality settings. You click on the XR settings and you have virtual reality support. You just check the virtual reality support box, and after that you will have a little bit of a small plus sign over here.
from where you can select Google Cardboard. On selecting the Google Cardboard, it will transform into a VR application, which you can mount it on your head devices and watch it. The AR application, you can only mount it on your head devices and watch.
Okay. I have
Abhishek Mandal, I have only three options in type. User defined, predefined, C cloud repo. From where did you get this type? Can you please mention? I couldn't get it. Sir, I have a 6GB RAM. Yes, 6GB RAM will work fine. Although the 6GB RAM would work nicely. No problem. You will have no problem. But when you will add more assets, like thousands of assets, if you are trying to build a big scene, so there may be a little bit of lag you will face. Okay. Is VR how, bro, in VR, how did you add the cube in the plane? Can you repeat? Okay, the cube. I will repeat it. In this VR application, the cube was added as a reference. The place where I will stay inside the VR, the cube was added as a reference. Go to the hierarchy, right click on it, 3D objects, and then click on cube. See, the cube is again added. This is the cube which is added. You click on it and delete. You don't need it. You just need it as a reference. Where does hologram come into the picture? Is it a part of AR? No, hologram is a different topic. This is a question from Prakhar Kumar. I have got this question before also. So this is a different topic. Hologram is like a projection. In augmented reality and virtual reality, there is no case scenario of projection. You just see it in front of you inside a device. And hologram is a medium. Like hologram can't be viewed on a blank space. It needs some sort of smoke or some sort of thick or opaque material where you can project anything, and that's the hologram. And the hologram concept is a little vague, as like till now the real hologram which we can make is that of a geometrical structure. Like we can make cubes, we can make a triangle, we can make a pentagon, like that. That's the hologram which we have successfully built till date. I don't know, maybe in future it will be transformed into, like, we can hologram a human, which we have seen in movies, but in real life that can't be done till now. Hope so, we will do one day. From image target, Abhishek Mandal, from image target, I get three options. Image target. Okay, you have, okay, let's go to the augmented reality application. Image target, Abhishek, in image target, go to the section in the left-hand side, in the right-hand side, the inspector window. In type, you have from database. You just need to click on from database. From image, from user defined, there are three options. From image, user defined. Okay, you are getting just three options. Then you haven't yet imported the image. You just need to import the image, Abhishek. You haven't yet imported the image from the Vuforia file. You need to import the image first inside the inside your application. Then you will get the option from database. Okay. Is it necessary to build the settings in Android? It does not work in PC. Yes, it works absolutely fine in PC. If you want to make the device for your PC, you just need to go to files, build settings, and click on build. That would be enough. But if you want to transform it into your mobile devices, I don't know. I don't think that VR will work in PC well, because we can't view it in that way. So it's better you transform it into your Android device and just play with it. Okay. So please tell how to download Unity app for PC. Although the Unity app can't be downloaded. Unity app for PC. For PC, you need to go to Google. Just search in the Google bars, Unity Hub. Click on it. You will see the first link, download Unity. You just need to click on it. And then over here, download Unity Hub. Click on it.
and then the download will start in Unity Hub. After that, you just open this Unity Hub, go to the install section, and inside the install section, you just need to add the version, whichever version you want. Then go to next and select all these checkboxes for Android build support, iOS build support, Mac build support, and click on next. And the Unity software will be downloaded in your device. VR, can you once show the lighting settings, how you change the dark to light? Okay, dark to light. Animesh Prasadi, I will show it to you. Inside the VR application, okay, let's do it once again. So there is only one directional light, only one directional light present over here. This is the direction light. We just need to, as we have worked in Word file, like control C, control and C, copy paste, the normal thing which we have done for so many years. We need to click on the direction light, copy and paste it. We will paste 2-3 different lights. We will make it make 2-3 different lights. We will select the control C, control V. We will do it, and all the directional lights will be copied for more than once. Like I have 3 directional lights over here, and then we have a view from the left side. Suppose this is the directional light. The light, you will see it is falling from the left side. The rays, see, there are the rays. It's falling from this side. So the light will be on here and this side will be dark. So to make illuminate this side, we have to add another light from the opposite side. For that, I have added this light from here. Just copy and paste the directional light and change the angle from the position here. Change the angle from the rotation section here. In the transform, you have rotation, you change the X axis. In the case of rotation, you have changed the X axis. I have made it 150. In case of another direction light, I have made it 100. And in case of the first direction light, I have made it 50. Set one at 50, set one at 100, set one at 150. And you will see a lot of lights facing over here. And this will help. Okay. So, another question. Sir, I can't view the questions over here. Is there any problem?
Questions?
Hello. I can't view.
Yeah, you can't find over. The questions. Yes. Okay, then see, I will just read out the last 3 questions. I think you have gone up to all the questions. Lighting setting, up to lighting setting you have read. Yes, after yes. That there is one question. I don't think that is quite meaningful. Anyway to integrate ML with AR VR?
Yes, absolutely. I am working on it. Means I am just making an application where we can, whenever you wear a head mounted device, you will just view, means whenever you make a head mounted device and install the application inside it. Suppose I look into a phone, the machine learning will detect the phone and it will show it that it will display that it is the phone. If you use a lot of data sets so that it can detect which company or which brand the phone is. Like if you are looking at an iPhone, it will say it's an iPhone. If you are looking at a Samsung phone, it will say it's a Samsung phone. Machine learning can be implemented. For that, you need to add Python APIs or OpenCV APIs, just the way we have added the Google VR API or Google VR SDK. We have to install the Python SDK or Python APIs over there.
Okay, so the last question over here is from Mr. Gautam Paul. Why SDK file is necessary only for Android?
SDK and NDK, JDK, all of them are necessary to build the application. That's the basic thing. It means whenever you are building an Android application, maybe you, if you have worked on Android Studio, I don't know if you have worked on it or not. Before, means a year ago, Unity does not have this option, means this Android SDK and NDK tool option. So we need to merge the Android Studio along with Unity and then make our application so that it works for the Android Android devices. SDK is a development kit, developer kit. Since developer kits are always necessary, SDK, NDK, and JDK. Three of them, all of them are necessary. So we have to add it. Otherwise, the application won't be built properly. The application won't be even built. You will get error while building the application.
So there was also another question associated with it. Is it only for Android? The question mark was there.
If you are building it for Android, then only you need SDK, NDK, and JDK. But suppose you are building it for an iOS device, for an Apple device. Here I am showing you on the screen. You just need to check this box. This iOS build support. You just need to check this box. Nothing else is needed. Android build support is not needed. You don't need to click on any of this. You can just switch it off and just click on iOS build support and then next, and you will download Unity. This will also work. This works for only iOS devices. But whenever you are going to build the application for Android device, you need to add the SDK, JDK, and NDK.
Okay, fine. But I don't find there are no more questions in the question panel. So I will look for the raised hands, but then also there are no raised hands. So if anybody wants to ask any question orally, can raise a hand, or if there is any other question, you can write in the question panel. I'm unable to find any question, any further question, and also there are no raised hands. Okay, there is two more questions in the question panel. Abhishek Mandal again asks, sir, in the GitHub link, which file we have to download?
Okay, I'm showing it to you. This is the link which I have provided to you. Just let me copy paste.
Okay, and also he asks source file or zip file.
Yes, you have to download the source file. I'm showing it to you, showing it to all of you. Just go to Google, copy paste the link. Here you go a little below. Here is the first file, the first one, a 33 MB file. This is the source file. Google VR for Unity 1.200.1 Unity package, the package file. You need to download it. You don't need to download the source file. You can download it and unzip it, but that's unnecessary. You can directly download the first file and then drag and drop it inside the Unity folder to start working with VR. So any more questions?
Okay, yeah, there are two more questions. One question from Mr. Gautam Paul. Please, can you see how to do teleporting in VR? That means, can you please show how teleporting can be done in VR?
Teleporting means how to transform it into an Android application or something like that. I can't understand your question. Teleporting.
I believe so. So I believe so, yeah.
Okay, so for that, you don't need to do a lot of changes, just what you did in AR. You just need to go to File, Build Settings, and this is what you need to do at the starting of the app. Means before building the app, you go to Player Settings, and then from there, you just need first go to Graphics API. Inside the other settings, go to Graphics API, and you will see a Vulkan value like this. I am showing you once again. Let me import it first, and I will remove it. You will see this will happen at first. A Vulkan API will be there, which you need to remove. You just click on it and click the minus button. It takes a few minutes. So is this the last question, or is there any other question? While it's importing, I can answer the rest of
it. One more question is there from Prokhor Kumar. Mr. Prokhor Kumar, what additional kits are needed while integrating ML?
OpenCV is a must. While integrating ML, OpenCV is a must. OpenCV with Unity. it is a great combination. You can do a lot of things with that. OpenCV is a must. Okay, so I have imported the Vulkan API over here. You will first, when you start the application, you will say it like this. This is the Vulkan API will be present. You just need to click on it and click the minus button over here. There is a small minus button. This will remove the selected list. So you click on it and the Vulkan API will be deleted. And the next settings which you have to change is go down. You have the XR settings. Click on XR settings. You have virtual reality SDK. Firstly, you won't have this checkbox open. You won't have this checkbox clicked. You just click on it. A tick sign will appear. Then you just select the Google Cardboard from there. And then you are good to go.
Okay, so that is fine. One more question, last question again. No, two more questions are there. One question from Animesh Prasadi. Is there any other way to perform the VR project? Because I have 4GB RAM on my desktop.
See, I would suggest you, if you have 4GB RAM, I would suggest you to use low poly 3D model. So just the way I have used. See, these are not so defined 3D models. Means the lion doesn't look at all like lion. It's a low poly model. It will easily work. You won't have any problem in 4GB RAM. But if you are slightly going to the higher end side, means the lion, you need to make the lion look like a real lion, and you need to add so many assets over here, you will face a little bit of problem. I would suggest if it's a PC or it's an upgradable laptop, you just upgrade it 2GB mode and make it a 6GB device, and you will be able to do all the works flawlessly. But for now, you just work on low poly models like this, where the structures are not so defined, and you can see a box type material, all of them. So this will work fine on your device. 4GB RAM, it's enough for that.
Okay, I think that's all, because Abhishek Mandal was requesting for extension of the meeting till he builds the VR application. But Mr. Abhishek, I believe what you can do is, I have already shared his email ID. One more time, I will do the same. I will just share his email ID. This is email ID. You may kindly be in touch with him, and if needed, you can also go maybe go for some personal WhatsApp calls or something like that. You can do, and if there is any such difficulty, you can do that. So that way, you can definitely solve it. But his email ID is definitely there. Over there, you can also ask for him any other way of contacting him. Maybe that is possible. But there is no further question and also no hands raised. So I think we can close the meeting now. But Abhishek, please be in touch in the email ID. He will definitely help you out. Okay. So yes, Prescom, your final words to complete.
So
your final words for completing.
So finally, we have built successfully two applications, one for VR and AR. See, the world is changing towards augmented reality and virtual reality. Means this is the best time. Means we are under lockdown. We don't have anything to do. Wait, I will share my webcam first. So am I visible?
Yes, you are visible, but static, maybe internet connection problem. Anyway, you can continue.
Okay, let me just. Anyways, there may be a submission.
You can.
Okay, so the world is changing towards augmented reality, virtual reality, and mixed reality. And this is the best time for us to work, as we have a lot of time. We are sitting in our home. We have a lot of free time. We can explore with it and see. Even OnePlus, we all know the brand OnePlus. They have they are launching a new phone, OnePlus Nord, and for that they are organizing a meeting which is organized in virtual reality. We have to pay 99 rupees for it in order to join the meeting in virtual reality, so that we can make ourselves feel like we are present inside the meeting. We are seeing all the launch, we can see the mobile devices in front of us. So this is where the world is changing. People don't need to go out. We don't need to go into different places on our own. We don't need to physically be present on a place. And we can do all the things sitting in our bedroom or in our dining room. We just only need to wear a handheld device and just slide in our phone, and we are good to go. If we now we haven't visited many places, like we had plans. This is the summer vacation is going on everywhere. In a normal time, it was summer vacation. We used to go to different places. You can just build an application. You can just build a place where it means you can just augment it, or in virtual reality, you can convert it into like Paris, or even you can go to places like Shimla, Kulu Manali, just sitting in your room. That's a very interesting thing. This is the fun part. But technically or in industrial level, works are going beyond your imagination. Means people are doing something which you couldn't even imagine. I recently saw a post where they just copy pasting objects from real life to the augmented life, just with the blink of their eye. This is what Google is doing. They are copy pasting the real world objects and just pasting it in our own laptop using augmented reality. So this far the work has gone, and the market has developed. Like in 2016, it was a $29 billion US market, and now in standing in 2020, it's a $217 US billion market. $217 billion US market. So the market is rising and growing towards virtual reality and augmented reality. I would suggest you all, you can try this field. This field is a lot interesting. You can do a lot of work, and there is a very less competition in this field. You have to work a little hard. Many things you have to learn. You have to learn about machine learning. You have to learn about 3D app building. You have to learn about C# language, many different languages. You have to learn about two different platforms. I have shown you in Unity. You can also use Unreal Engine. So a lot of work need to be done, but that's that's worth a penny. You will get a great result at the end of this. So that's all. I hope you all liked my sessions, and you will also be able to build great applications in future. And make sure you build all the applications and let me know if you face any problem.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you, Shreshkam. So thanks to all the attendees, all the participants. Best of luck with your application building. So happy days to go front of us. Thank you. Thanks to all of you.